Ooh, ooh, a little Iroq Topstring. Interceptor 7. As usual, we center up the string and the mast, and we use on the, it goes 9, 10, 9, 10. The 9 we use at the top, fold it over once. And then on this packet, we go, there goes my Milwaukee. I was born in Milwaukee, was there for 3 months. Still got that accent though. Let's see. So we go through the 4, start in the center, go through the 4, keep it nice and tight up here on the first one as the ball goes out nice and smoother, nicelier and smoothlier when the second one is tight. For clear physics reasons, which I will not share with you because I do not know the reasons. Otherwise I would share them with you, obviously. But it works. So we're not gonna fix. Okay, now we just noticed that if you're tighter, you put these out here, ball comes out a little clunkier. So you keep the front ones, the top ones, the lead sled doggers up tight. Now I'm moving this, just swinging this little bit over to the centers here. Doesn't seem like a big deal, but if I don't do that, it looks awkward. And then probably works awkward. It probably figured itself out. Okay, so then we do loop them around with the top string packet again. Well, there I'm going for some Long Island accent. To the garland, to the garland. We'll hang out with our friends in the garland. So this is a drop top pocket in the sense that ball comes out low, ball stays low. Ball sits in the middle for the most part. Doesn't really fling around much. But it's a great pocket. And you gotta figure, lacrosse has been around for 500 years. They know it's been around for 500 years. Not the lacrosse that we know. Not the modern gladiator game. But the French trappers accompanying priest back 500 years ago noted the game in his logs. Not his log, his journal. Probably slept on a log. And then, so we know it was 500 years old. So what's not to say it's not 1,000 years old? I mean, really? Why not? So let's just say lacrosse is 500 plus years old. And they've been stringing these bad boys for over 500 years. Half a millennium of stringing. Which brings us back to, I got a friend, he's a outside at USC now. He loves his like chipo, his, I don't know what it is, but it's like an old pocket, you know, on a little circle. A little wooden circle with some kind of pocket ball holding device on it. But I don't know. I had traditional back in first I had soft mesh, but that was crazy back in the day. It had 15 different shapes a day depending on the barometer, depending on the humidity and temperature. Just the material was different, and I don't know, the stringing might not have been as good. But then I had traditional mesh, and one of me leathers broke in the championship game. And I got over it, a lot of therapy, some medication, no, I'm just kidding. But not happy about that. So that's why we started to use parachute strings, up front to, fix this. Wrong hole. Okay. Okay, right back at you. Where was I? Babbling. Sorry about that. So here we have a setup up top. Swing this over here, make it even, taut. You want to have it nice and perfect up top here. So ball's going to come out around here, which is great. So again, now you got to make sure that you don't have too much play up there. We've shaped the mesh to begin with, which is nice, because then we don't have to do too much. The mesh itself and the pocket itself will do most of the work of the shooting strings. Key is to just make sure this doesn't have too much whip. And you see here, this is interesting. You see how this is angled here? That's key, because you got the tautness, and as it comes down, the holes are closer. Sometimes you double it up. Sometimes if it's too taut, depending on where the holes are in your head. So sometimes if it's too taut, I'll do it here. You can double it up. So that gives you some looseness. Now why would I want looseness? Because it's nice and tight, and now I can add some bag down at the bottom. You can take care of the top. Got the shooting strings lined up, and this one goes up here. Shooting string slash mesh lined up. So now, just gonna finish her up. Finish her up as on this side. Sorry, I know it's taking forever. Some things take forever. Like that's the number, this one here, this hole right there. Gotten a lot of complaints about that hole. Too small. That's why we use this mini string. 2.75 30 seconds. Whew. But look at that. Just whooshes right through there. Might be through experience. Alright, so as you see, this is nice and tight up here. We're gonna do the same thing. From here. So which ones is dragging through? I did it tight up here, see? That's why I was able to double down on that. This one in the center. He's coming up. That center's coming up. I feel it coming up. Yeah, nice and tight. See these? The angle it's on? Yeah, see the angle it's on there? And then it diminishes. The angle diminishes down here as the mesh lines up. Oh, like almost no angle. Okay, sorry. Wasting your time. Time is valuable. Time is money. Here's the double up. Even though I'm battling, I remember that. Isn't that great? Alright, almost done. Now, this is pretty much it. Now, we're going to put a V, a little mini V. More of a U in there. And you can put anything you want up in the top. As long as it's above 4 inches. 5 inches. As long as it's above 4 inches, you can put your initials in there. But we like the V because it has a little pop effect. Channels the ball out, gives a little pop. So there we go. We know that the ball is going to come out right here. I don't have any whip. Ball got a nice old bucket right at the top. Bucket all the way down, as much bucket as you want. And we'll put these will go through here. Okay, sorry about that. Great-grandfather. Great-great-great-great-grandfather on my wife's side. Had some thick Italian accent. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Let's see. Oh. Alright, so you got that. The old backaroo. Yes. And plenty of extra string there for whipping around. And then again, nothing there. So we'll just put a little V-bert in here. It actually doesn't do that much, but we'll take every little bit. That's what we love to do, is take every little bit. And then come down here. And we're almost done. This baby's ready to go. If it wasn't for that 2-inch string rule, that you could only have 2 inches of excess string hanging off your head, this thing would be a whipping machine. The back of it has a whip. Because of the string. It's like a kite. kite rooster. Rooster kite head. So, that's really it. Eventually, this will poke through here. Like that. I'll give that the old canoodle knot right there. And, hoo, there you got it. Sweet Topstring. This comes bucket right through here. This deep old bucket. Yeah, hello, hello in there. And then it comes ripping, snorting out of here. Hits into the V. Gets the moonshot effect as the ball pressures up the V. Shoots out. Beautiful. There you go.